We start our new chapter, which is chapter 5, that involves Transformer. Okay, this video, which is the first part of the chapter 5, will consist of theory. In the next video, we will discuss about turn, voltage and current ratio for the transformer. We only focus on ideal transformer. And lastly, we will discuss on the theory of the transformer losses. Okay, there is a little bit of calculation in it. So, what is transformer? A transformer is an component. A component widely used in power system. Okay, what it is function for is to lower or increase the AC voltage and AC current level. Okay, power doesn't change a lot. Okay, in ideal transformer, there is no power change, no power loss. Power input is equal to power output. Only the voltage and the current changes. Okay, and it is also AC only. If the supply is DC, transformer doesn't work. Only in AC the transformer work. Okay, and a transformer can transfer power from one side to another side at the same frequency. Okay, when you use transformer, if the input side has 50 Hz, the output also have 50 Hz. It doesn't change the frequency. Okay, only the voltage and current change. Okay, without any electrical connection. Okay, the first connection and the second connection, and the first circuit and the second circuit, the source circuit and the load circuit has no any electrical connection. It's only linked with the electromagnetic link. As mentioned before, the first circuit and the second circuit are isolated. There is no electrical connection whatsoever between the first circuit of the transformer and the second circuit of the transformer. This isolation is very good in protecting the electrical system. Okay, if you can see here, in electrical power generation system, transformer is used to generation station to raise the voltage from 22 kilovolt and to a higher voltage, which is around 275 kilovolt, either 132 kilovolt, 275 kilovolt or 500 kilovolt. You can refer to the chapter 3.1, which is the theory of the three-phase system. And also, this slide should not use single-phase transformer because the power generation system in Malaysia use three-phase system, not a single-phase system. Okay. Why we increase the voltage? Because to reduce the current, and we can send further away because we can reduce the power loss because of the lower current. Okay. Make sure that you know that when you use transformer, you don't change the power. If it is an ideal transformer, the power is not different. Okay, only the voltage and current are changing. When the voltage increase, the current decrease, and the voltage decrease, the current increase. As mentioned before, there are different circuit when it comes to transformer. It can be minimum 2, usually input and output, or maybe more. Okay, but usually for this class we focus only on two side. Okay, the primary side, okay, which is usually at the left hand side, okay, which connected to the source, and the secondary coil or winding, which at the right hand side. So mostly secondary winding is connected to the load. Okay, the primary is the source, the secondary is the load, and it is at the center of it. You have to know that there is a core, usually shown as a two straight vertical line. Okay, and the primary coil is like an inductor at the left side, and the secondary coil or winding look like an inductor at the right hand side. So you have to know how to draw the transformer. Make sure you know. Don't forget to put a vertical line to show that there are core in the transformer. It's important for you to know the difference between a core type transformer and shell type transformer because it might come out in the theory of your in your final exam. So if you look at the left hand side, you can see that it is a core type transformer. Okay, core type transformer means that the primary winding and the secondary winding are winded at the different location of the core. Okay, you can see that the lower part has one side of the winding and the upper side, upper winding is for the other circuit. And if you look at the right, that is the shell type transformer. Okay, shell type transformer, okay, the winding with primary and the secondary winding are laminated together at the same location of the core. Okay, so it like a sandwich on top of each other. So you have to know the difference between the core type and the shell type transformer. And also you have to take note that there are, okay, if they use iron core, it is laminated iron core. You cannot use a one iron core connected connected together. It needs to be laminated to avoid eddy current loss. We will discuss that in the third part of this topic. Okay, and also you have to know that it use a enamel insulated wire. If you look here, it look like the wire has, yeah, they just wind it together and no insulator between the wire. But actually there are insulator. It just very very thin. It's almost like a painting. Okay, the wire is put inside a painting. Okay, that one is called a LML insulated wire. Okay, the operational of a transformer is also important. It is usually will be asked in the theory part of the question. Okay, how transformer work? Okay, for in Malaysia, we use a 50 Hz AC voltage source. Okay, then this AC voltage source, okay, will wind the primary goes into the primary winding, and it will induce the magnetic flux inside the core. Okay, the magnetic flux will expand and contrast in the primary winding. Okay, the expanding and contracting of the magnetic field around the primary winding will cut the secondary winding and induce an alternating voltage into the winding. Okay, and as a result, the voltage causes alternating current to flow through the load. Okay, so you have to know how it is operate. Usually the mark for this type of question are usually around 3 to 5 mark. So you have to remember, memorize this. We have discussed the component of the transformer before, which is the core, which is provide the path for the magnetic field of the flux. The primary winding, which is connected to the AC source. Secondary winding, which is goes to the load. And lastly, don't forget the enclosure, okay, which protect the component above from the moisture and mechanical damage. Here we discuss the characteristic of the core. Okay, first thing you have to know is that you have to know the what type the composition of the transformer is depending on the factors such as voltage, current, and frequency. So different voltage, current, frequency, different core you have to use. Okay, commonly the material for the core is air, soft iron, and steel. Okay, each of this material suitable, sometimes suitable for certain application, sometimes not. Okay, you have to know that air core transformer are usually used when the voltage source has high frequency above 20 kHz. This is to avoid saturation. Commonly to avoid saturation. But for iron core are usually for low frequency, such as in our system we use a iron core because it is lower than 20 kHz. Soft iron core Okay, transformers are useful because it is small and efficient. Okay, iron core transformer provide better power transfer as does in the air core transformer. So this one you only have to memorize. Okay, a function of laminated sheet, okay, laminated core is that it is easier for the heat to dissipate, okay, which means that the core will not get hot too much. If it get too hot, it will become there will be no more power loss. Okay, if you still don't understand what is lamination, okay, it's basically like a layer cake. Okay, you have to put a layer of metal sheet and then put some non-conductive material like varnish, then put another steel, then put another non-conductive material and so on. So the function is quite important because it's avoid power loss. Okay, either can be dissipated as a heat, okay, heat problem, okay, or a eddy current problem, which will be discussed later. Okay, it's also important to know that the most efficient transformer core is the one that offer the best path for the flux to go, okay, in the magnetic and electrical energy. So basically, lamination is quite important when you designing a transformer. Okay, now there are two types of core we use in the transformer. Okay, don't get confused with the transformer type, okay, which is the core type and the shell type. Okay, this is the core type. Okay, the previous one is the transformer type. So the first type is the hollow core. So basically it's just a square with a hollow center. So this is the hollow core transformer. Okay, this is the second core type, which is called shell core transformer. Instead of a square or rectangle with a empty space at the center, this core use E-shaped core and I-shaped core, and it joined together to form a core with a two hollow point. Okay, as you can see in the picture. Okay, if you can see in the picture, this is a shelf type transformer with a shelf type core. Okay, so this is how to build the winding. Okay, build it first, then put the core together. This is for the shelf type core transformer. We have discussed the first point and the second point, but the third one is, you can see that there are insulated paper placed between the layer of winding. The function of this insulation paper or non-conductive material is just to provide an additional insulation. Okay, because the wire is already coated with the varnish, okay, to provide an insulation. But sometimes the varnish can be not very good, so we have to provide an additional insulation from the paper. Enclosure is just a basically casing for the core and the winding. Basically, the transformer is placed inside the enclosure. Okay, so what is enclosure? Okay, if the transformer is small and installed inside a device, don't have to put an enclosure. Okay, the air will act as insulation and heat transfer agent. If that is true for the small device, but for a large device, okay, the voltage will be larger, so it placed at the outside, which it can get rain water. So you have to put an enclosure, usually steel. Okay, it's just to isolate the internal from the environment. Okay, and usually this enclosure will contain oil that provide insulation between the enclosure and the transformer, as well as the heat dissipation. Okay, just to transfer the heat from the winding and the core. Okay, this is the end of chapter 5, part 1. We will continue part 2 in the next video. Okay, make sure that you know the theory of the transformer, because this is usually 20 to 40% of the mark of the question.